So, friends, as we have discussed that there are various sources of finance. Now, it is time to take an overview regarding the classification of such sources of finance which we are going to learn in our this chapter. Okay? So, let's do the classification by making a flowchart first, and after that we will learn about each and every basis as well as the actual sources of finance under this. Okay? So first of all, if we will talk about the classification of sources of finance, your classification is done on three bases, where first one is your on the basis of period. Secondly, it is done on the basis of ownership. Thirdly, on the basis of sources of generation. Okay. So, first of all, coming towards the on the basis of period, that is, it may be possible, see, depending upon the time. That is, for how much time you require fund, you will go with different types of fund. Say, in case you require fund for a short period of time. Okay, that is, say, within 1 year. Okay, you require funds for just for 1 year. Then, in that case, you will prefer short-term finance. Short-term finance. Apart from this, if you require funds for a medium term, that is from 1 year to 5 years, okay, so then you will go for medium term finance. And thirdly, if you want long term finance, that is finance for more than 5 years, then you will go with long term finance. There are few categories in which your medium term loan stands just for 1 year to 3 years, okay, but and long term depends upon, in that case will be more than 3 years, but apart from this, if we basically talk about, it is within 1 year, it is more than one year but less than 5 years, okay, and here it is always more than 5 years, okay. Now, what are the names that are classified under these categories? First of all, talking about long-term finance. If you require finance for more than 5 years, it is your equity share capital. Yes, we will learn about these, but I will start talking to you about these here, it will take more time. So, being just go with the summary, we are just learning about the listed names under these categories. For long-term finance, one can go for retained earnings or your debentures, your preferential capital, share capital, your loans from bank, either from banks or financial institution or banks as well. Okay, that is in case you are taking loan for more than 5 years. Now, apart from this, coming toward medium term loan. Okay, medium term finance. For medium term finance, one can go for loans from bank or financial institution as well, but that is from 1 year to 5 years. Okay. Or one can go for lease financing. What it is, we will do it in a separate class because it is important point to learn with, okay, because it will gonna help you in future. Next one is your public deposits. So these are the various sources of finance for which one will go with medium term finance. Coming toward the short term finance, for short term finance one can go with trade credit, that is by raising creditors, by purchasing on credit. Next one is your factoring. This is also an important concept. We'll do in separate class. Banks and financial institutions and your commercial papers. Commercial papers. Okay. Now, if we were, these are the topics which we will discuss on the basis of period. Now, coming toward your on the basis of ownership. So, on the basis of ownership, one will go with either honored finance. Honored funds or borrowed funds. So, first of all, I forgot to discuss on the basis of ownership. What one mean by on the basis of ownership? See, by on the basis of ownership, one mean that what kind of control one wants. That is, what he wants to earn all the profit for himself or in future if he require, he would like to share his profits as well. That is, in case he require large funds, and it's obvious that one will go with borrowed fund, as if he can't have so much funds, such huge funds, he is required to borrow, and in that case he is also required to share the control as well. Similarly, in case of honors fund, if he is investing all the funds of himself, that is even the shares as well, as if we have discussed that owners are basically the shareholders, right? So even in that case, the owners are investing, then in that case it will be the owners fund. So what are the categories one can discuss under the owners fund? It is either your equity shares or your retained earnings. What one mean by retained earnings? As if we have discussed this twice, so just let me give you a small overview over it. By retain, what one mean is by keep something under this one's control, right? That is not distributing basically. So if we'll talk about the retained earnings, it is that earning which the firm had earned, but apart from that, it doesn't distribute it with the shareholders, but apart from that, it plug back into the business, then in that case it will be known as retained earning. Okay, now coming toward borrowed fund, if we will talk about borrowed fund, so one can go for either debentures, mortgage loan, loan from bank loan, or loan from financial institution, lease financing, or your public deposits. See, now one more thing, as if the same name we have discussed before as well, but they were on the basis of period. Now it doesn't matter that whether one had borrowed or have its own fund, but they can borrow either for long term or for medium term or for short term, right? That is why we had discussed the same names on the basis of ownership as well. Okay, there are few other names, but these are just few examples. Now apart from this, if we will talk about on the basis of generation, sources of generation, that is from where you can generate the source of finance, that is from where you can raise the capital. It is basically the place. Okay, if now one can either raise capital from place of sources, not the place as if some area, okay, it is place of sources. So one can either go for internal sources or external sources. So by internal sources, just like the owner, one can go for either equity share capital or retained earnings. Okay, and if we will talk about external sources, one can either go for Just like the borrowed fund we have discussed, these are somewhere same. One can go for financial institution, loan from bank, public deposits, preference shares, commercial paper, trade credits, lease financing, factoring. There are so many other external sources. So friend, this is the normal classification we have discussed regarding the sources of finance. Okay, in here it is just an overview from regarding which we are going to learn under this chapter. Okay, in our various classes we will gonna learn regarding these names in details, and for that you are required to download our classes Scholars Learning. And in case you have already downloaded our classes, you have already purchased our classes, then hope you guys will gonna utilize our classes very well. Thank you.